camera just now. Okay. It's open now. You good?
Hey, what's going on? It's Naquana Tashe, and I'm here. And of course, it's Let's Chat. I have my new official DJ here, and we're just gonna ask him some questions. His name is DJ Shad P. So introduce yourself.
Check, check. DJ Shad P.
Don't be all nervous.
Check, check. DJ Shad P on the check in.
Okay, okay.
Here with Naquana and the Pot podcast. You know.
It's called Let's Chat, powered by the Pot NYC. So, we're just going to ask him some questions, as I said. How long have you been DJing, and why did you decide to get into it?
I always knew music, and I've been DJing about 2 years.
Okay.
But music is something that always been something I did. I used to rap. A lot of people don't know that. A lot of people do know that, but I used to rap, and rapping wasn't working for me, so I said, let me just try this DJ thing out.
Okay, so you feel that you're more comfortable and more in your zone DJing?
Oh, yeah, definitely, definitely. Okay. I mean, I still could rap, you know, if I
you
wanted to.
You still got the bars?
Yeah, I still got bars. I prefer to do this. It's, you know, I can get paid for doing something that I love. You know, so that works for me.
So growing up, did you have, like, what was your, like, sound? Like, in my household, it was more of, like, old school, like, Otis Redding type vibe. So, like, what did you listen to?
Growing up, my mother only played Mary J., Faith, Biggie, the other guy. We ain't gonna speak about the other guy, but...
Why? Why not?
We're not gonna speak on another guy, but we used to listen to him a lot.
Okay.
I mean, anybody that was hot, we was always going to the CD store. It's called The Wiz.
Okay.
We was going to The Wiz every week. Whatever came out, we would get that. Whatever CD, Wu-Tang.
Okay.
My mother listened to a little bit of everything.
So, okay, that's dope. So that
I grew up on the old school, too.
Yeah, that kind of explains, like, your music style. Because you play, like I said, you play, like, old school. Not old school, but, like, older music. And then you bring it back to current. Like,
exactly.
Just
so,
now you
I try to mix it up because everybody doesn't like all of that new stuff.
Yeah.
So you'll be playing a set of Meek Mill and Drake and all of that, and it's not making anybody dance.
Right.
You know, everybody's just standing there like this. Like, so I don't really know if they're really feeling it or not, but when I play some older stuff, you know, R&B is going to make them get into their bag and, you know, get into their vibe and start dancing. And, you know, once the drink's it, they're going to start singing it. So, goes from there.
Okay. So, what's, like, your go-to song? Like, because there's some parties where you go to and, like you said, everybody don't really dance. People don't dance anymore, period.
Yeah,
like, it's like, you know, you gotta have those certain songs that, like, you put on. What's your song that you put on that you know gonna turn the party up?
If I wanna turn the party up new, I'm gonna Act Up, City Girls. that's gonna have the dudes in their bag, too.
Right.
I'll be on the mic where the City Boys at, and, you know, they engage with it, so, you know, they fucking with it.
What old song would you play?
Old song?
And I would say Dude Brown.
Nah, I don't really, you know, I played Doodoo Brown a couple of times and it never really went off.
Doodoo Brown is not it.
Yeah, like, it's not it. Even, like, Back That Ass Up, it depends on where they're at.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? But I'd say any crowd is gonna, like, two-step before I let go. Hands down.
Okay.
Hands down before I let go or Cameo.
Okay.
Cameo, Candy. Either one, you know, it's gonna give
us. It's gonna give us a little bop. Definitely. Okay. That's it. I feel that. Okay, so I just want to know, also, what's, like, your top three, like, favorite artists?
Top three favorite artists of all time?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you're going to laugh, but Bobby Brown is one.
I'm not going to laugh. Bobby Brown is it.
Bobby Brown's one of my favorite artists.
Mm-hmm.
Jay-Z.
Okay.
And,
that's always somebody's in somebody's top.
What would I say? Old Cam. Like, I grew
old
up
Cam?
On, I grew up on Cam, like, from, like, 97 to about 2002, before the computer's Putin and all that.
Okay.
Yeah, that's when I was like a big
when
kid.
He was like doggy style on the hamper.
Yeah.
That verse get on my nerve. Like, I cannot stand that verse. Yeah. Whatever. I told you I seen Cam last night at the Harlem World show.
Mm-hmm.
He was in there chilling and shit. And we're going to also have a discussion, like we said, about the Dipset.
Yeah,
times.
We can do that. Another time.
And like I said, I would say everybody's top three is like Jay-Z. I would say my top three is Lauryn Hill, Andre 2000, and Kanye.
Okay, that's an interesting top three.
I know, right? I think it's real subtle,
real
conscious.
I just wish Lauryn Hill came out with more music. You know, it's hard to say, like, I mean, don't get me wrong, that album is still, I can still play it from front to back, but one album, we needed more.
Mm-hmm.
You get what I'm saying? It's like she never was able to really reproduce that, so.
Okay. I mean, I feel like it's a lot of artists who didn't have, they couldn't really expand their music, especially people who were like taken before their time. And that's why everybody always put like Biggie and like Tupac in their collection. It's like, I love them as legends, but it's like they didn't have enough time to like give us.
Well, Tupac had a little more time.
He had a little more time, but like,
well, a lot more time actually. Yeah. But he put out so much. He could still put out something now. He got that much music. Biggie's catalog is kind of done. Everybody already knows all those verses that we haven't heard in a while. You know, we know them. But Tupac, he can still put out a verse.
I instantly think about Dave Chappelle's, that's why I laugh, Dave Chappelle's episode when it's like he has songs and it's like current songs. Yeah, and like, what the fuck? Like, that'd be Tupac's music. But as far as DJing, what would you consider your craziest like moment during DJing? Like, I seen on your Instagram.
What, people talking to me?
No. I seen that too. Okay. You don't like people talking to you?
Nah, I don't mind, like, you know, a quick what's up, you know, hello, whatever. But when somebody's trying to hold a full conversation,
right,
it's like, I'm here working. You know, I'm looking at the crowd, I'm surveying the crowd. Are they messing with the song? If they not, let me get it off.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? Let me talk to the people. Somebody in my ear talking to me, I'm forgetting the next song I want to transition
into. Okay.
You know, so it kind of just throws me off.
Yeah, distracts.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
That makes sense. I would say, do you get, like, a problem with people, like, giving you suggestions for songs? Would that be included as talking to you, too?
Yeah, I mean, that's going to happen every time. But
yeah.
The way you keep that at a minimum is to do your thing. Because if I got the crowd moving and everybody dancing, nobody really can't come to me because all I got to say is, look at the crowd.
Right.
They dancing. You know, you're going to get your girl sometimes where you do a party and it's not really a reggae crowd.
Yeah.
And then they come asking for reggae and it's like, it's not really a reggae crowd, but I'll get a little bit on for you.
Right.
You know, so you gotta really just talk to people. Like, I got you. Knowing I'm not gonna play it sometimes. Like, yeah, I'm gonna play that. And knowing I'm not ever gonna play that, but you gotta tell people what they wanna hear, you know?
I've been the girl before that be like, yo, can you play this? I'm like, yo, this nigga didn't even play the song.
But what's your reason? I always like wanna ask people, what's your reasoning behind that? Like, you wanna turn up right then and there, or?
Sometimes it's like, it depends, honestly, because if I'm at a party and it's like, what kind of occasion it is.
Okay.
Like, if it's, like, an outing for, like a birthday or something, and you know that one song where, like, I know I'm about to go off, like, that's when I would request the song type shit. But, like, I'm not just going around, like, yo, you gotta play Tekashi 6ix9ine. Like, no, I'm not about to just ask for, like, random ass requests. So, you get what I'm saying? So, like, I feel like it just goes for, like, why you out type shit.
Why
you know?
Out? Okay. Yeah, for DJs definitely don't like requests. But I get it when the DJ is stinking the place up, you're not playing no good music.
Yeah.
I get it. Come, if I'm playing some bullshit, come to me and let me know.
Right.
Listen, what you playing? I mean, I'm going to see it because I look at the crowd. I'm going to look at the crowd and see that they're not moving.
Mm-hmm.
But if they're moving and then you coming to me and tell me to change the music, I'm not really hearing you. You
right.
know, because at the end of the day, who's getting paid for this?
That's true.
You get what I'm saying? So.
And if people are already dancing, you really
if people are already dancing, people came for a reason. You know, people came to hear me as well. I mean, people listen to what I'm doing. So you just take a seat. You
right.
get what I'm saying? And if you want a DJ, you can buy your own equipment.
Right.
You
know? Let me hold it down.
Yeah, exactly. Hold it down. Get the old school when you get in the car. You know, but other than that, let me handle this.
So, if you can give some advice to, like, any up-and-coming DJs who's trying to, like, come out and who really don't have, like, the courage to really do it. Because I feel like DJing takes a lot of courage.
Yeah.
Like, some people's listening, like, what they listen to is not really what everybody else listens to or, you know.
I just had this conversation the other day. There's a difference between club music and car music.
Exactly.
So now, what may be your song could be a car song.
Exactly.
That's hot in the car, but in the club, everybody's going to be like, what is this?
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? And I'm trying to think of a perfect song where I could explain that. Like, okay, what's the song with 21 Savage and J. Cole?
A lot.
Okay, so that's a good track. But in the club, it's kind of like, you get what I'm saying? Like,
that's true.
Like, who's really going to dance to that? You get what I'm saying? Nobody's really going to turn
I'm
up.
I'm being a little fake ratchet, though.
A lot. You know, like, just on those parts, though. Not on the whole song.
No, yeah, it's true.
But if I play some Beyonce, that's really going to have you in your bag.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? Some Beyonce, some City Girls. You know, even, what's the new girl's name? I just played it in the spot on Sunday, and it went off. Big Old Freak is the name of the song. You know that one yet?
You're going to have to play it after this. So I can get a little ratchet, because I feel like you got some here.
Yeah,
Big Old, I probably actually know the song. That's the funniest part. My best friend named
Big Old
Nisha,
Freak is like, I give it another 2 months,
it'll
be just as big as City Girls.
Big Old Freak. I went to, I told you I went to the show yesterday, and it was a few fire songs. I'm going to have to slide to you, because they were fire.
Bet.
All right, so, like I said, this is Shad P. He going to be here every time we do a Let's Chat episode, so get familiar. And he's going to also be answering questions later about some hot topics. He's going to play a little game with us. And we're probably going to do hot seat too. So stay tuned. You can play some music.
Okay. Like big freak.
She has a video for this.
This is gonna be a journey.
The crazy part is, I see her at South by Southwest last year. And I went to this. It was like this little rinky-dink show. And like, that's what I'm saying. I wasn't going this year. South by Southwest shows, unless it's like big shows, it's not really it. Like, I don't know. She was fired.
It's going on right now, right?
Yeah.
Every girl that knew it,
I just put one of her her freestyles on my blog site.
Okay. Even the album with him and all of it, like, it's supposed to, like,
Metro Boomin' words is fucking fire. Fiesta?
Yeah, bro.
Fiesta
remix.
Fiesta remix. Fiesta remix.
Fiesta remix. Fiesta remix.
After the show,
and then the nigga stayed current through like 3 decades. The nigga can't. I'm a flirt with
T-Pain.
T-Pain, the nigga, like, he came through mad different songs.
That's just crazy.
Get over it.
Say what?
Get over it.
I'm upset at the man. Like, yo, what's wrong with you, you creep?
Yeah,
I mean, up. That's the thing.
And the dumb part is he records everything. Like you're dumb, my nigga. Like, honestly, like, niggas do shit. Like, in the industry, all those people, everybody did shit. Like, everybody did shit. That fucking Bill Cosby shit, when niggas fucking pulling up, talking about he did this, he did that. That was the shit back in the day.
They were and doing that shit. Not, way moves
yeah, like, not even condoning that shit, but niggas was doing that shit. And all these that right. shit.
I didn't know that when I was a kid, that the tape that came out, like, was a child.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody was...
I knew that shit.
I don't remember how old I was. I think I was like.
I remember how it looked.
Might have been like 6th or 7th grade or something like that. I can't remember how long ago it was.
How old are you now?
30.
I'm 31.
Alright, so yeah, I was in like 7th grade. Yeah, I was 7th grade.
2002.
Oh yeah, cousin had that shit on the VHS.
I remember how the actual, like, the DVD shit looked, the bootleg DVD, like, cover and shit. Yeah. I remember how the whole shit looked. I never watched it.
He was saying it was his brother.
Nah, I watched
that's fucked up. That's fucked up. Yeah, that's fucked up.
It wasn't his brother. I don't think it was his brother.
It wasn't. It was him. It was him. In the documentary, his brother was like, yeah, he tried to blame it on me.
It ain't got that much light where it could have been.
No.
No.
Like, yo, his brother, the one that's locked up, is a dickhead.
His brother is a dickhead. Nigga said, whatever he did that shit.
Yeah. Nigga said, you know, I don't understand what's the problem. Everybody got a preference.
Everybody got a preference. Yeah. He just like young girls. Nigga, shut the dumb ass up.
Nah, the question that he asked, that shit is worse than the first question, the Torre shit. When Gail asked him, do you like, are you an old man?
What kind of
women? And he said, I'm an older man and loves all women. Uh-huh. That answer was worse than
when Tori asked him, like, hey, girl, like, whoa, wait, what are you talking about? We're 16 age, like, only 2 ages where it's consensual, where it's okay. That is different. Like, it's no point, like, I wouldn't even do an interview, like, nothing you say is gonna, I don't even know who allowed him to do that interview.
I think he's trying to,
I'm
at
a lifetime,
but, I don't think he's they're exploiting people's, like, shit, like,
they want to hear that stuff from them, but then it's just like, don't want to hear it. And that shit's definitely in love. That's 6 minutes long. I think I should just let it play.
Let it play.
Go to the bathroom.
Yeah, that was my bathroom break. Because I know they want to touch the whole shit. You know, they want to hear the end.
Right.
You want to hear that one.
The whole thing.
The whole song, bro. DJ, they want to hear all of that.
The DJ, what?
That's what they say, bro.
Right, all right. We back with Hot Topics, and we have just a few to discuss. We had a good little conversation behind the scenes about R. Kelly, too, so I might have to drop that in. So stay tuned for that footage on the Pod NYC as well. The first thing that we're going to talk about as far as Hot Topics is Aunt Becky from Full House. She... And I'm going to just say Aunt Becky because we know her as that, but she was arrested, or she's going to be arrested. She's in FBI custody for some, like, scandal, college, SAT, like, finagling. Apparently, she had some issues with that. She paid, I think, $100K for some changing of information for her daughter. Was it her daughter?
I believe so.
Her daughter?
I believe so.
Let me read the exact because I don't want to lie. FBI's reporting that Aunt Becky, Aunt Becky, has surrendered connection with the college admissions robbery scandal. She is scheduled to appear in court this afternoon. Prosecutors allege that she and her husband, fashion designer, paid $500,000 wow. to have their two daughters labeled as recruits for the University of South Carolina, South California crew team, even though neither of the girls actually participated in the sport.
I mean, you know how long it's probably been going on?
Yo!
This is probably something that's been going on.
And I'm over here busting my ass, and I just need a famous parent to fucking tell me, tell somebody that I play basketball or some shit, like...
See, I feel like in other races and other cultures, they're quick to pass down things quicker than we are.
Yeah.
You know, like, you'll see, somebody who's Caucasian will own, let's say, a cleaners. Their great grandfather could have owned it, and it'd be somewhere in the hood, but they'll keep it because their great grandfather owned it.
Right.
They'll just keep passing it down, passing it down. I feel like with us, we own stuff and then it gets run down. You know, like you'll see a new store open up in the hood, and everybody goes to the new store for 6 months, and then before you know it, chips is on the floor. And
right.
It just, you know, people don't keep up the maintenance.
Right.
You know. So.
I mean, it's not, like you said, she's not the first person to do it. She's just, like, the biggest name as of now.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, the internet is going to be undefeated as usual and track every meme about Aunt Becky.
I just seen a few already.
I seen a lot of them.
I seen, what's the father, Danny?
Yeah.
Danny was talking to DJ.
Yeah.
Your auntie's going to jail.
Aunt Becky's going to prison. Yeah. So, yeah, I don't know. Like, I feel like you said, it's more of, like, the culture of the people that's doing it.
Mm-hmm.
Because if it was, I mean, not to say I'm happy, like, it's being, you know, brought to light. But, like, if it was African Americans, it would have been brought to light. Because since she's been, like, in custody, it's been other people who's been, like, put to light who's done it. So it's like, where was this exposure before?
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Exactly.
I don't know. I feel betrayed because Sally Mae is still at my door.
Yeah, I'm still ducking Sally Mae.
And niggas is getting fake scholarships out here in the streets.
It's crazy, man. It's crazy. Like I said, this shit been going on probably for years.
No, yeah. And like I said, someone else, I forgot the actress' name, but she paid someone to change her kids' SAT scores.
Okay.
So, like, it just says that we think that we don't have the advantage, but we really don't have it, and then it's also being paid for us not to have an advantage.
Yeah.
Like, for someone who's busting their ass every day to get an SAT score of this, and someone can just pay $10,000 for you to change my score, like, did I even take the test?
Exactly, and if you reach $10,000 is nothing.
Nothing, that's fucking gas money.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, I'm hurt, I'm appalled. I think Navient, that's who takes my student loans, I think they need to go and do some calculations and figure this out, because I'm hurt, honestly.
What happened to the student loan forgiveness that Obama was preaching?
Yo, honestly, a few people got it, though.
You know, I thought I signed up to something,
and
then I seen on the internet that it was a scam, so I canceled it.
Oh.
But, I thought, it was like, yeah, you're only going to be paying, $70 a month.
Was it like 12 months?
Yeah.
They called me, too.
Yeah, and I'm like, oh, it's lit. So, yeah, let me sign up. And then once I, like, really looked into it, I seen it was a scam. So I got a whole new card and everything because I hadn't given my card information.
Yeah, that definitely happened to me. And they do, like, it's certain steps that they do. Like, a lot of those, when people call you, and not to sound racist as fuck, but, like, a lot of them are, like, they have, like, the Indian accents.
Yeah, yeah.
So, like, and like I said, not to sound racist because I got a few Indian friends. But you have to really question a lot, like, ask certain questions, because they will get you. Like, and especially at that time, especially when you're a vulnerable college graduate, like, who don't want to pay back student loans. Like,
they know that.
They know that. And then when Obama was, like, preaching, like, student forgiveness, that was, like, the biggest, like, scandal and scheme that people can do. Mm-hmm. So, like, you just have to be really, really cautious of what you say. And it's still going on, because I've been getting emails, like, in my junk mail about it, too. You just have to be careful and conscious of what you're saying, because as soon as they start asking for socials and, like, credit card numbers, I'll be mad.
That's when I'm good on it.
Yeah, I'll be like, what you need that for? I can cash up you.
Exactly. Yeah, I'm cool.
I cash up you every month.
Venmo something. Yeah.
All right, next hot topic, we have Odell Beckham. He has been traded to the Cleveland Browns from New York Giants.
Actually, a lot of people are going to be mad at me. I'm an Eagles fan, so I'm kind of happy about that.
I mean, I just rep New York all the time, so.
I mean, I try to rep New York.
Besides the Knicks.
I've always been.
I can't fuck with the Knicks. Sorry.
I go for the Knicks. I don't like the Nets. I go for the Knicks.
Okay.
You know, I want to see the Knicks win. I want to see them do better. But when it comes to baseball, I like the Mets.
Uh-huh.
But when it comes to football, I'm an Eagles fan back from Donovan McNabb days back in the day. But as far as Odell getting traded, I think it was stupid on their part.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you're not going to get a young talent like that ever again, probably. This guy is one of the best receivers to go down and hit. When it's all said and done, he'll be one of the best ever.
Right.
And you traded him away for what? You
know? I was about to say, who did they trade him for?
They traded him not even for one player, for this player, Jabril Peppers.
Okay.
And then a first-round pick and a third-round pick. Now, a first-round pick, you're going to get some talent, but it's not gonna be Odell.
Right.
You know, like
Odell did fucking ballerina moves. Like
Odell's different. And Odell is seasoned. He's been around for a while. He knows what he's doing. Everybody that's from New York that has a Giants jersey is an Odell
jersey. I'm
about
to say, yeah.
It's not an Eli. It's maybe now Saquon Barkley. Maybe now because new guy. You get what I'm saying? But Odell is the face of the New York Giants.
Right. That,
you trade him away.
Yeah.
Just don't make any sense.
That's
you get what I'm saying? They're not trying to win. That's all it is.
It's yeah.
Yeah. They're not
it's like what was your purpose?
Point? Exactly. Exactly. That was
you shaking your head. You feel away. You can speak. You can speak, Eddie. You have like a whole cameo in the last episode about eating fucking jerk chicken or whatever the fuck you were eating last time. So you can speak. It's okay. let me see. The next topic is YBN Almighty and his 300 stitches after getting jumped.
Yeah, that's crazy. I feel bad for the little homie.
He didn't deserve that. No. Like, honestly, like, why do people hate him so much? Like, I know he talk a lot of shit, but that's all artists, like, all young artists trolling.
I think that's the problem nowadays is that these artists have these personas. And then, I don't know if you remember, but maybe about 2 weeks ago, he robbed another rapper.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that shit when they ran up on him.
Yeah, and he robbed another rapper with Rolex and all of that. So, I don't want to say he deserved that because nobody deserves
that. Right, that's it. That's
but when you're living that life and you're portraying yourself as that, now you come to New York and you're posting your location. People is like, yo, I'ma get him.
Right.
I'ma go get him. Yo, let's go get him. And they already know you got beat up the night before or whatever it was.
Right.
So then now you post it again, your location, they're coming again. The wolves is out. You get what I'm saying? People just gotta be smarter. This whole internet thing got everybody foolish.
I'm about to say, that's the tricky thing about social media too, because
it's
like
too much. It's
too much and it also gives you too much information about where you are. Like my godfather, my uncle told me that all the time. Like when you're traveling, like don't put that shit up until you come back.
Your
location is not required for anybody but yourself. Like, you don't need to fucking, I'm here, come true. Like, I don't even like when I go to events to like put like the geotag shit.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
That shit is mad annoying. Like, especially for like bigger artists and whatever. Like, my nigga, you know you got beef. Why are you gonna put
Why
this
are you
here?
Doing that? Yeah. Even a while ago, Hell Rail tagged that he was in some spot and he had beef with these Long Island dudes. And he was eating in there with his family, and the Long Island dude ran up in there and beat him up.
Oh my God!
Beat him up with his family there, chasing him out the spot. And I mean, it's the internet, you know, because they got into something before.
Right.
Then Hell Rail tried to downplay it, saying it didn't happen.
Mm-hmm.
So then they was mad about that, like, yo, we gonna beat him up again. So when he was out in Long Island, which I don't know why, at some kind of buffet with his family eating.
They thought it was an international.
Yeah, he tagged. Maybe international buffet, exactly. Maybe somewhere over there. He was in there eating with his family. Them dudes ran up in there, and they put beats on him.
I don't fuck with geotags. I like probably put like your mama house, like some dumb, shit. But I'm not putting where I'm at. Like, I'm not putting where I'm at because end of the day, like people want are envious. People want are looking for confrontation, especially if you have. Mm-hmm. Drama or you have beef, like, so
exactly.
Like there's no point of you
exactly.
That's like all right, come get me, like my nigga, no, tag,
I mean,
your it, no, what do you
feel
mean?
Like in every field there's some type of competition,
yeah,
you know? And people are jealous, you know, even with me DJing, I've only been DJing 2 years, but I could feel like jealousy and
mm-hmm.
People like, oh, how do you get this, how do you get that, and how do you get this gig, you know, but it just comes from working. If people like you, they're gonna, you know, take a license. So it is what it is. I try not to focus on anybody else's. I'm not looking at nobody else's plate.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? If my plate is full, why am I worried about yours?
I have too much on my plate to even think about
yours. Exactly.
Like,
exactly.
I got too much. I'm trying to fucking figure out for my damn self.
Exactly.
But as far as YBN, I hope he has a speedy recovery because they already gave him a new name.
Yeah, YBN Scarface.
Like, I hope you're doing better because that's not even cool. Like, honestly, that gash was like here.
Mm.
So like, and it was deep.
Yeah.
So
that may be for life.
That is
for life.
This is probably gonna
past surgery type shit.
But like, how much past the surgery can you like without looking different? Like,
I mean,
you know what
think
I mean?
About it. When Maino got cut, he still got
he
cut.
Has this. Yeah.
Got, you know, like,
and he's when, young.
Yeah. He uses the skin. I think it's type of skin.
Huh?
Keloid skin.
Yeah. Like when you
that's still crazy. He probably still gonna have a scar.
When you get cut like that, you have that keloid scar.
Didn't get a beard.
Huh? I guess that's the best bet.
I look at your beard like,
yeah, get a beard. Yeah, YBN, if you're listening, get a beard.
Yeah, like, that's all, like, no funny shit. Like, that's sad. Like, he has a gash here. He He had a gash here. Like, that's just...
It was two?
Yeah. It was a really big one right here.
But and what, then it was what like did he a, do for niggas to hate him like that? Because I feel like when you stab somebody or cut somebody, that to me is...
premeditated.
Yeah, but that to me is worse than shooting somebody.
Yeah.
Because you actually have to walk up to them.
And get close.
Yeah, you get what I'm saying? So you poking this person up, and you feeling every time you poke them, you see in their face, you get what I'm saying? You shooting somebody, you shooting from a distance most of the time.
Right.
You get what I'm saying?
Most you like people, watching their pain.
Most people is not shooting to kill. They're shooting just to shoot.
Yeah.
A stabbing, you're really looking to hurt this person. And
especially in their face. And what I read, it was like a Henny bottle. Don't be messing with the dog, because I fuck with that.
That's probably what it is. Niggas are drunk off the Henny.
Yeah, like, and Henny bottles are thick as fuck.
Yeah.
Like, I know.
It broke the Henny bottle?
I don't know how it. What I was reading is that he got it was caused by a Henny bottle.
Wow.
Don't be using my goodness for that.
Yeah, to hit somebody with a bottle and it cracked, that means you hit them with a hog.
Yeah. I've seen it.
Yeah, I've seen it happen before too.
Were we at the same spot?
I don't know. Somebody got cracked with some Moet.
Oh, nah. I seen a Henny bottle get cracked on somebody. That was my friend, too, so.
Oh, damn.
Niggas still being watched, by the way. But that's another story. But, yeah, speed of recovery to YBN, because, like I said, he didn't deserve that. Nobody does. That shit is fucked up. And whoever did it, they're probably gonna get arrested. Like, I'm pretty sure they're probably
because they're not smart criminals. Nobody nowadays is smart criminals. Everybody do these crimes and then they wanna boast and brag about it, not thinking that the cops is on social media too.
Another fail of social media. Like, you can't fucking beat somebody up, stab somebody, like, rob them, take their chain, and yell, take their chain, and then be on your Snapchat.
Perfect example is 6ix9ine. Social media helped him, but it hurt him.
It destroyed him.
Destroyed him at the same time.
Free my boy.
But I mean, what's like really?
I love 6ix9ine.
Yeah.
Free my boy. I'm sorry, you snitch.
I like 6ix9ine music, but if you was portraying that street life,
yeah,
you gotta stick with that. So now you look crazy snitching. You can't come out and put out no more music.
But the crazy part is, I feel like he can't put any music out for us, but his audience is a lot of white kids.
Okay.
Who aren't so familiar with like street shit. Like, they're still gonna listen to that shit.
Yeah, but then if somebody else did, like, is disrespecting them, like, how?
Yeah.
He was like, yo, we ain't jacking that.
Yeah.
And, you know, like, they'll start, like, oh, you know what? They might have liked them for street cred.
Yeah.
So now they don't like him because of that.
Yeah.
Like, figure, people used to like 50 because he got shot 9 times. So now, what if people found out that he was lying? You get what I'm saying? They would be like, they would kind of be like, damn, like, did you didn't really get shot 9 times?
Yeah.
I mean, we know he did. But you get what I'm saying?
Yeah, like, I get it.
Yeah, so.
Damn. Free my boy, though.
Yeah.
You gotta go back to Daniel now, because you can't be 6ix9ine.
I don't really play his music anymore.
It's not the same.
It's not. It's over.
It's not the same. Like, I'm one, like, if you play 6ix9ine, I will usually go, like, crazy. And I don't even get, like, hyped for 6ix9ine no more.
Yeah.
Like.
See, I played, what's the drum tour name? Kika?
Yeah.
I only play the hook.
Damn.
As soon as, like, his verse is about to come on.
That's the hottest part.
It's the hottest part of the song anyway. Yeah, exactly. Even Stupid, I used to love playing Stupid, and I don't really play Stupid anymore. I don't play. I've been stopped playing Gummo.
Damn, 6ix9ine.
Yeah, I mean, it's so many joints I don't play no more. You know, and like I'm telling you, he had a whole set. I used to play a whole 20-30 minute set.
Because he used to get this shit fire.
Yeah, like, Stupid.
I mean, he's only been out for a year.
Stupid
so
used to go up.
I guess we can go back to what we're doing.
Tati used to go up.
Yeah.
You know, Rondo, Billy. He had joints.
He had fire. All his songs were fire.
All his songs were fire.
You can't deny it, but free my boy, yo.
Yeah.
That's all I gotta say. All right, so we're gonna get back into some more music. We're gonna come back. We have a little game to play with Shad P. See if he knows, because it's Ladies Month, see if he knows real females' names behind their identities as artists. So stay tuned.
Yes.
This is my song. Is this
the
recording?
That's
it.
You got it the
right time?
Did it come to you? Don't take no offense, but you my bitch. Yeah. You gon' fall through every time a nigga call you. That's why I ball, how I ball when I
spoil
you.
Let me respond.
I can feel like 80 rats in my Mary's.
Me and Jesse back to back is getting scary.
If you fucking with my eyes, don't come near me. Put some
bitches. You're listening to DJ Shad P.
Okay, guys, welcome back to Let's Chat. As I said, we're just gonna do a little game. and we're going to ask Shad P a few questions. Eh, wait, what are you doing? You just fucked up my whole vibe. Fucking sneaking and shit. It's good? Okay, I'm going to start again. Okay, guys, welcome back. We're going to play a little game with Shad P. We're going to be asking him a few questions based on artists' names, but they're only female. So, and of course, they're their real names. He has to guess their stage names. Okay? You ready?
Wish me luck, y'all.
All right. I'm just going to say the first name. Okay. For this person. Katora.
Katora?
Mm-hmm.
I can't get the last name?
Nah.
We're going to do like Family Feud pass.
What do you mean pass? No, you got to guess. It's a All right. I'm going to give you a guess. She's a female rapper. And she's in our generation.
Katora.
Mm-hmm.
Saweetie? I don't know.
That's a good guess, but no.
Okay.
Her name is Younger May.
Oh, wow. I never would have guessed.
Right? I didn't want to say from Brooklyn, because that would have been like...
I would have thought her name was Larry or something.
Oh, no. Not Larry. I thought her name was like Melissa. Like,
something manly.
Okay, something manly. Larry, though.
Yeah, not that ass. Okay. I mean, something that's unisex or something.
Let's see. Gabriella Wilson.
Gabriella, oh, that's Azealia Banks, right?
No.
No? Oh, I was confident about that.
You was bad confident. Yeah, like, you got her digits and some shit. Yeah, like,
Gabriella Williams?
Wilson.
Wilson?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know that one.
Her.
Oh, yeah.
AKA Gabby.
Yeah.
Let's see. Shantae Harris. She's older.
Yeah, that's Tiny. Right?
No.
No?
Harris. I know Harris is going to get you. You got none right, by the way, bro.
I'm going to get some right. Don't get it twisted.
Shantae Harris. She is...
Trina?
No. I should have guessed Trina because I don't know Trina. Is Trina named Trina?
It might be. I don't know.
I'm going to bring that back. you give up? I'm going to give you, like, multiple choice.
No. I don't need a multiple choice. Just give me one hint.
Jermaine Dupri.
Debrat.
Okay. Nigga, you guess three people. Like, it's, at this point.
What you like?
Marlena Evans.
Damn, this is complicated.
It is, right?
Shit. Give me a hint.
Shout out to Women's Month. This is actually hard. He picked this one. So blame him. I don't know any hints, but she's a female artist. Mm-hmm. She is very underrated. She has short hair, and she killed a BET cypher like 2 years ago. Oh, my God. You got any hints? Rap. And she can rap.
She can rap?
Yeah.
She's popular?
She should be more popular, but she's popular.
Got to pass on that one,
too. You got any more hints? Because I don't have any more hints.
She rap.
Then we said that. Rhapsody. You don't listen to Rhapsody?
I've heard of her. I don't know who she is, though.
I mean, you didn't get Younger Me.
I should. I'm ashamed. I don't know who she is, but...
You should Google her, yeah. But her, yeah. Okay. Solani Imani Rowe.
Goddamn. Selena Imani Rowe. Where is she from? Give me that. You can say down south, up north, west coast.
She's from here.
She's from up north?
Yeah.
Selena?
Mm-hmm.
That ain't Cardi, because Cardi is like Bella Cass.
Berkeley's, some shit.
Yeah, some shit.
Berkeley's.
She's from up here. I don't know. I don't know that one either. I give up. Who is it?
I was about to start singing a song to give you a hint. But then I started doing her voice and it just made me laugh. SZA.
Oh, yeah, I definitely want to laugh.
And the last one.
Damn, can I go at least go, what, 1 for 10?
Bruh, you trash.
These are hard. You ain't give me no Carisha or John Tavia.
I didn't want to give you like the Onika.
City Girls, you know.
I figured those are too easy.
Yeah.
I'm Matthias Amelia Kelly.
What? I'm Matthias?
Yeah.
That's a bad name. Shout out to her parents. Give me one hint on that.
She's a terrible rapper and she has a ghostwriter.
She's She's a what?
She's a terrible rapper. She has a ghostwriter. That's the rumor.
And she has a ghostwriter. And she's a terrible rapper. Dream Dog?
Oh, no. No. Iggy Azalea.
No, I mean...
It's a Dream Dog.
I heard she got a ghostwriter. That's what
her
I
name
said.
Is... What is her name?
Shit.
Find out in the next episode. Yeah, okay, yeah. So Shad got zero out of six. I'm going to just give you, like, next Melissa week. Elliott.
Oh, missing.
He got one, guys. He got one.
Shit.
Okay, so we close off the show with a little motivational quote. I don't do it. I let the guest, but this time the guest is who's going to be the DJ. So, Shad, do you want to give a little motivational quote to anybody listening or anybody watching?
Whatever you're doing and you feel like it's getting hard, just keep pushing. Because, you know, the good times is coming. You got to go through the bad times to appreciate the good times.
That's a fact.
So, that's really what I want to tell anybody. Just don't give up.
That's a big fact. Yeah. Okay, guys, I'm Naquanita Shea. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. This is Let's Chat.